Petite La Femme, the red light flashing. One half up into the air. Steadies again, Petite La Femme. They're racing now. Wonder Kind deep out, one of the first to hit the ground. From the inside, gathering speed is Exonet, and also Ignite the Fire, Petite La Femme prominent. Behind them, Cable Boy, Bondonna easing back. Rangarole posted wide there from a sticky gate. Driving up Prize Pennies along the inside of that pair. Then came the Slug, anchored back to second last on the outside of Steel's The Deal. And so along past the 750, it's Exonet down on the inside, just in front of Wonder Kind. A length and a half away then is Petite La Femme, the mare pushing up on the inside from Ignite the Fire. They're followed by Cable Boy, who's posted three deep outside of Prize Pennies. Rangarole is tracking Cable Boy. Off the fence now goes Bondonna there, was able to quickly extricate off the fence. The Slug is second from last on the outside of Steel's The Deal as they set sail for home. Sweeping into the stretch at the 350, and Wonder Kind hit the lead from Ignite the Fire. They beat off Exonet. Petite La Femme is zigging and zagging her way through as Cable Boy launches its run at the 150 metre mark, and Cable Boy surging to the lead here for Johnston Porter. Races clear of Wonder Kind, Petite La Femme. Cable Boy won it in a canter. Cable Boy easily from Wonder Kind, Petite La Femme. Prize Pennies might have just grabbed fourth, and then the Slug, who's running on late ahead of Bondonna, Rangarole. In behind them, Steel's The Deal, Ignite the Fire, and paddling over the final stages after leading to the corner is Exonet to bring up the tail. Cable Boy, written by Clint Johnston Porter, has raced away to score its maiden victory, the Oratorio three-year-old. Let down sharply there once Johnston Porter released the brake. Did get shouldered three deep, probably at about the 750-800 there to the home corner, but certainly quickened up very well. Wonder Kind was always prominent, and Petite La Femme looked fleetingly a real chance, but then once Cable Boy let loose, the race was all over. And this three-year-old by Oratorio from Surrendering, owned by Ronnie Beecham, and trained by Adam Durant, ridden by Clint Johnston Porter, has won in effortless fashion. A length and three quarters the margin. Second home, number 12, Wonder Kind, first up by Gingerbread Man, Brad Parnham. And third, number 7, Petite La Femme, by Safeguard, Matty Derrick. 4.12.7, 9 has finished fourth, Prize Pennies on return, and the time is 1.12.86. 35.55 is the closing 600. 1.12.86, 35.55 the sectional, 1 3/4 by 1 1/4. So Cable Boy home at its second career start, came off a solid return behind Trade War down at Bunbury, and has taken a big step forward there in winning race number two. Wonder Kind, a handy enough return by Gingerbread Man out of Flying Angel for Nev Carolyn Parnham and Ronnie Sayers, trained by Neville Parnham. And third placing to Petite La Femme, a Safeguard La Vie en Rose mare, owned by B. Turner, trained by Chris Willis, ridden by Matty Derrick. And behind those, Exonet gave up the ghost there, paddled pretty badly. Bondonna was a battling run. In fact, there was a whole cluster of them there in behind the place getters. The third, the Pimm's Handicap over 1,200, where there are no changes to come. They'll jump at 1.44 as we take you downstairs. Let's catch up here with Britt Taylor following this victory. A very good return by Cable Boy. Probably a little unlucky not to have finished a bit closer to Trade War on that occasion, but certainly has taken a good deal of experience out of that debut run.
Certainly looks that way. Darren, Jason Miller from the stable joins me now. Jace, is that how you saw the debut run, a little bit unlucky not to have finished closer?
Yeah, look, he just got a bit slow out and got back and ran on well and just didn't get real flow into the race. So look, it was a good effort and he's obviously improved second up.
How did you see today's race unfold?
Probably how it did. I thought he'd be just behind the speed and hopefully let down well, and he did.
Is there a thought in the stable that he'll be able to go through some grades now?
Yeah, the way he hit the line today and he let down, he looked the winner a long way from home. So he's definitely got a lot of upside and he'll be going through some grades.
Will he be better over further still?
The way he hit the line there, definitely going to... he definitely will get a bit further.
And how is Tin Snip later in the day in his return to racing?
Look, he's been trialling really well and he's been working well. So let's, he didn't, he just he had a off prep last time. He just couldn't find any form, and his form fell away from his 2-year-old. So hopefully he can get back to a bit of the old tin snip that we know.
Well, let's hope we see the true tin snip later today. Well done on this one.
Thank you.
There from the Adam Durant stable, Cable Boy, just his second career start, breaks maiden status, and looks like there's a few more wins in store for Cable Boy. The Oratorio gelding out of Surrendering. Clint Johnson Porter in the saddle.
Just to be near you, baby. Heart open, testify. Tell me that I'm not crazy. I'm not asking for a lot. Just that you're honest with me. And my pride is all I got. I'm saying, baby, please have mercy on me. Take it.